Hey guys, welcome back. Thanks for joining me today. We're going to go through Lightroom workflow. I'm going to be really honest with you guys because things have changed. Given the crisis that is happening right now, it is April of 2020 if you're coming here from the future. In the situation, I lost clients for my actual day job, but then have since gained a lot of them and now it's really busy. So I'm going to try and record a few videos in the days that I record videos and then edit them. So if I look exactly the same, including the same clothing and the same hair and the same makeup and the same blemishes, let's not forget, then that's probably because I was already recording another video either before or after this. I hope that that makes you guys feel loved because I'm giving up my very few free days again. How times have changed. Life's gone flipped all upside down. I'd like to take a minute just sitting right here to tell you how to take photography pictures that others will fear. In today's video, what we're gonna be doing is we're gonna be in Lightroom, so make sure you've got Lightroom open, and I'm gonna walk you through exactly what I do from import to export without the editing bit in there. There are loads of editing videos that I have done, so if you wanna see a full edit of one image broken down into easy steps, then head to the series, which is linked above, and if you want something super specific, either drop it in the comments below or check out my recent uploads. And yeah, let's go. Hello everybody, this shoot was done in 2013 on the 29th of July, so we are, you know, close to being 10 years ago here, and this was when I literally just started out as an actual real life dog photographer with a portable studio. So this shoot is done in the client's home, and that is important to note because this would not be a setup that you would have in a studio. However, like I said, this was about 12 bazillion years ago, so don't judge me, okay? The purpose of this is basically to go through how I would handle and cull all of the files. This current folder is literally all of the files from that whole shoot, so we're on 491 photographs. What you want to do is you want to go ahead and import the images to Lightroom. If you don't know how to do that, just, you know, go ahead and watch a YouTube video or whatever to import your images over and catalog them in your hard drives and your folder system. If you don't know how to do that, then let me know because I'll just make another video with that in it. So how do I handle my files? Well, first of all, you want to go over into the develop module, and then what you want to go ahead and do is go down into the bottom here where it's filter, and you want to do filter, and then you want to pick flagged. I'm hoping you guys can see that over there. So yeah, you want to pick flagged, and then that will automatically go onto anything that is flagged. We have not flagged a single thing, and therefore we click the middle flag as well, which is everything that is unflagged. What that does is it leaves aside, and we don't click on the last flag, which is rejected. Now, interesting thing here is that you use your keyboard to flag stuff. So we're going to separate the wheat from the chaff, the good from the bad, the selected from the rejected. And how we're going to do that is we're going to use two keys, X and P. X means bin it off, get rid, gone, bye-bye now. P means pick, selected, winner, winner, chicken dinner. Are you with me? So what we want to do is we want to go ahead and just put some like basic stuff, basic adjustments, you know, things like white balance that suit the whole shoot. We do want to be able to make sure we can go into 100%. This is technically 200%, but we're not going to be picky about that. Basic edits, we're looking at things like exposure, your white balance, we're looking at highlights, shadows. We're going to leave the blacks because that's an individual image situation. We can also, if you want to, look at texture, clarity, dehaze, vibrance and saturation, as well as your core other changes, which are sharpening. If you are stuck on how to do your sharpening, I will link a video up here. Open it in a new tab and finish watching this one first. Yeah, you just want to go ahead and make your first amendments, like so. When you're happy that you have made the correct changes for the shoot, I know I went outside at the end of this shoot, so I'm going to stop at the bit where I didn't go outside, but we've got the first image selected. Can we see that here? We've got the first image selected. We're going to go ahead and go to the last of the photographs taken in the same setting. Da, 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 da. We're going to hold down the shift key and then we're going to click on the last picture. Da, 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 da. And then we're going to go sync and we're going to just check everything because we've not done anything else. And we're going to press synchronize. And what that does is that puts all of those settings that we've just done on all of those pictures. So now what do we do is use your arrow keys on your keyboard to flick through and reject images that are soft. What do we mean by soft? This is soft. This is sharp. This is the eye. This is soft. So we exit off, rejected, and it disappears from the bar at the bottom. However, it still exists. It's just in the rejected flag pile. This is, you know, half and half. And we're just going to go through and first things first is remove anything that is soft. Okay, so once you've done that, you can go right back to the start of all of your pictures. And then what you can do now is you can pick your images based on what looks good and know that every single one of them is in focus. So what we're going to do now is we're going to go through and essentially select the images that are the best in terms of what the subject is giving us. So for this, for the purposes of this, I'm really looking for literally the best of the best in terms of what I can make into a stunning portrait, not what I would present to a client. So I'm going to cull this harsher than you guys should. You can always do one or two or three different passes through the images. And what you want to completely avoid is too many that are super similar. So let's take, for example, these headshots of the mother here. So if I hold down the shift key and just select these headshots and then head back out to the library section and then view it as this loop one, what that does is it brings up what I have selected just here. Now if I was to present all of those pictures, I mean none of them are amazing, but if I was to present all of those to the client, they would find it really hard to pick the best picture from them, when actually I can just go ahead and make this process so much easier by picking between the similar ones. So this is this one and this one, and to be honest I do prefer that one. So and then these three are extremely similar, so we want to pick the best one. I'm going to go with that one. And just like that, we've whittled them down. So you want to go ahead and keep using your X key to reject anything that you think is less than amazing. And you want to keep anything that is amazing by pressing the P on your keyboard. Okay. Anything that is absolutely blowing the world away because it's so freaking amazing, you need to go ahead and press the 5 key, number 5, on your keyboard. And what that does is that gives it a star rating, makes it super easy to be able to go back and find your best photographs later on. So I'm going to go ahead and follow the principles of this. Like I said, I'm looking for the best of the best. So I'm going to press X on anything that isn't absolutely stunning and absolutely, you know, impressive in terms of a piece of portraiture. So what are, if I'm going to look at all of them again, what would be my 5-star picks? I think these two, when they're merged together, will be amazing. I think this is amazing. And I think this is amazing. I'm going to pick the rest just so that we're fully covered. So once you've finished, anything that's left is your picked pictures. So if you take off the not flagged tag, you will just be left with the pictures that you are going to go ahead and edit. Now at this stage, you can use Lightroom to do your pre-edits if you're moving into Photoshop afterwards, or at this stage, you can go ahead and export to open in Photoshop. Select all of them and you want to then go ahead and do File, Export. And then in export, you want to go ahead and pick your folder that you're going to export these images to. This is edited raw files. We choose that one there. Okay. Don't have any of these checked. We're still on specific folder. We're renaming to Labradoodle Puppy Re-edit because it's 2020 and this is a re-edit. And then the image format that you want to use if you're sending them out as to edit in Photoshop is DNG, which is a digital negative file that will retain all of your information with it. If you're exporting because you've finished, go ahead and use the JPEG setting. You want to make sure quality is at 100 on JPEG, sRGB, Don't resize to fit. Resolution at 300. You can sharpen for screen, low or medium, either way, and then export and off it'll go. Like I said, we're going to do it as a DNG file. So we're going to go DNG. We're going to set it to the newest version of Camera Raw that you guys have available. The JPEG preview is irrelevant. Use lossy compression, make sure that it's unchecked, and make sure embed original raw file is selected. Then export. And there you have it. If you've liked what you've seen in this video, please press the subscribe button and click the bell icon. The bell icon helps you out because it gives you a notification every single time I upload a video. All of my videos are centered around dogs, dog photography. That is the general consensus. However, pretty much every single video can also be used for any other type of photography too. So yeah, see you soon.